Good afternoon. My name is Jim Conlan, and welcome to the latest episode of our entertainment show. As you know, in part three of our entertainment show, each week we premiere our new TV series or movie that's debuting in Ireland and the UK in this upcoming month. And up for discussion this week is a police detective show following on from the smash hit The Rookie. We have a new spin-off series called The Rookie Feds, which is debuting here on Channel Sky Witness in Ireland and the UK since February the 8th. And it stars an all-star cast, including Niecy Nash. We have Britt Robertson. We have James Lesure, Kevin Seegers, and our special guest this evening, the one and only Felix Solis, who plays the character Matthew Garcia. And I was just talking to you before we came on air, Felix. It's a busy time for you at the moment, and everything seems to be going rosy with The Rookie Feds. It seems to be very much head on in terms of shooting and production. Is it busy at the moment?
It is. We're closing in on the final couple episodes of a 22 episode season. And anyone who knows anything about a long-term television contract, you know, it's a marathon, it's a long run. So you have to always pace yourself and make sure that you don't burn out. But by the time you get to the 20th, 21st, 22nd episode, you sort of have a little bit of looking forward to the break, if you will, energy. But yeah, we're going strong. We're currently doing episode 20. As we speak, and then we will be overlapping 20, 21, and 22 to see if we can get it all in under the deadline, you know, which is to try to get it all in before the proper break comes in the television season.
And is this a sort of a follow-on from The Rookie, which starred Nathan Fillion? Is it in terms of aspects and sorts of characters? It's just maybe expanding us from The Rookie was the police department. Now The Rookie Feds, is it more going nationwide, dare I say?
Absolutely. I mean, I think you're right. I think there is this, there is a strong movement, and we're sort of proud to be a part of it, of making this The Rookie a universe, you know, similar to the way that the Chicago universe and other networks have these universes of these television shows. They all sort of revolve around the same sort of premise. And with ours, it's always second chances. It's always a new beginning, a second chance at life. You know, each of our shows our show revolves around a character that has had a full life and is now trying to start a new one, you know, at a later age in life. And it's always a very interesting thing when you put someone who has a lot of life experience in what would be considered a rookie situation, a rookie circumstance. And in our particular show on Rookie Feds, Niecy Nash plays what would be considered one of the more older rookies at the FBI at Quantico, and going through and being a rookie trainee and being an FBI trainee. And I play Matthew Garza, who is the head of a sort of outside the box thinking group that he's put together to see if he can sort of shake up the traditional way that the FBI goes about approaching cases and solving cases and bringing justice to those who need it. And so he kind of picks up on the fact that she is sort of a unique person. She's a wild card, if you will. And he thinks that that's going to be a great asset to the FBI world. And so he brings her on and sort of joins forces with the other wonderful characters that you just mentioned early on in the introduction, and the other actors who were playing these characters, who are all, in a nutshell, outside the box thinkers. But yes, this universe does pick up on the rookie energy, which is the formula, which is that it's about giving someone a second life, a second chance at life, and a kind of resurgence and a kind of renaissance to someone who would traditionally be thinking about either retiring or being, you know, out of sort of too young, too old to be in something that is considered a young person's world, you know. Yeah.
And Felix, tell me, how did the opportunity come about for you to get cast as Matthew Garcia? Was it the original talent agent process in terms of audition? And were you able to audition in person, or did you have to go through the initial rounds through Zoom, or were you sought out?
I didn't. Thank you for asking that. I didn't go through the traditional route, but only because there was sort of a time crunch in when we were going to start shooting the two backdoor pilot episodes. I was currently on a show at the time when it was happening. And so therefore it was sort of a very quick do you want to do this? If you want to do this, say yes, and we'll do, and we'll go for it, and we'll move forward, and we'll let it happen, and we'll make it happen. And I read this, the character, and I thought about it. And I also know Alexi Hawley from the past. I did another show that he created called The Following, which was on Fox, which was this wonderful suspense, again, FBI sort of thriller series, where I played an FBI agent. And so I think the familiarity of what it was that I had done for him in the past, coupled with the fact that he sort of saw in me, I guess, something that is working in the character that I'm playing now. And so the process wasn't as traditional, where I put myself on tape or I went into the room and I auditioned. I simply just read the part. I told him I'd like to do the part. I was excited about playing something that was polar opposite to a character that I had just come off the screen playing. And so therefore it was kind of perfectly matched in timing for me to be able to not feel like I was stuck in one kind of character or one kind of category of character. And so I kind of jumped at the opportunity to be able to do that. And that's what Matt Garza is. He's the complete opposite of the last character I played. And for an actor to be able to go full pendulum swing as many times as possible in their career is always a welcomed opportunity. And so I kind of jumped right at it. Yeah. So I didn't go through the traditional route, but I would have been more than happy to do so, because I thought this is something I want to do, which is completely opposite of what I just did. Yeah.
And I suppose, Felix, signing up to a TV series, obviously actors all want to be working, and they obviously is in terms of paycheck, but signing up to series where there's initial 22 episodes in season one and a strong possibility in terms of getting renewed, you never know, for sort of future seasons down the line as well. Being involved in a project that could maybe lead to maybe 70, 80, 90, 100 episodes, is that sort of, as an actor, is that the sort of grind you want to get into? Because when you commit to those projects and they really kick off, it doesn't really give you time to do anything else, dare I say.
Yeah, that's a good question. I think we all ultimately want to be able to work consistently, right? We kind of just want to do our work and be able to do it and not have to seek out. The world of an artist, the world of an actor specifically, has always been considered a feast or famine kind of career that we choose. And yes, you always want to be working. And yes, and it's interesting because there is a little bit of a be careful what you ask for, because you might just get it. And in regards to that, there is absolutely I'm going to use the word affectionately, a grind. There is a grind to it. And I'm a very working class person. I come from a working class family. And so therefore the work and to do the work and to get up every morning and do the work and the grind of it is something that I'm very familiar with. It's something that I'm not afraid of. It's something that I actually feel more comfortable in. That being said, one of the things that I think is most important when you start to look at it long-term is that you want to make sure that you build a character that you can access at any given moment, at any given time of your energy level, at any given time of your day, at any given time of your focus of. And what I call that is the default, right? The default character, the default acting that you put in place for the character you're going to play. If you look at it over the long haul, if you do the hard work up front, then your default will always serve the character you're playing, whether you're tired, whether it's episode 20, whether it's episode 1, whether it's episode 100. If you've put the character together properly and you've built it in a way that you know that no matter what, you can do this, and I use the term loosely here, with your eyes closed, it works. And so the hard work for me was to do that in the beginning and to take the time and to focus on building that, so that in the long haul, in season 2, season 3, knock on wood, 4, 5, however many the universe has decided we will be doing this show for, I will be able to do that no matter what, you know. But some people don't. Some people unfortunately fall into what is a trap, which is to think I have to go hard and fast every day right from the beginning. And then you start to wonder why it is that you're waning, why it is that you're feeling at a loss for choices and decisions and references for the character you're playing. Why is it that you find yourself not being able to keep the lines in your head? Like all of these things. And I think it's because it comes, if you go at it hard and fast, which is an excitement and a thrill, you will burn out. And I think that the thing that works the most for me was I had to make sure that I foundationally built a character that no matter what, the default would always serve the purpose, you know?
And I suppose with the FBI, obviously, it is serious topic. It's serious conversation. So I'm just wondering in the premise of this, are we going to see storylines where there is, dare I say, things of a real graphic nature, things of maybe where people, close friends, people like that may pass or something? Or is it sort of mellowed, sort of down? Because when you're dealing with stories like the FBI and sort of thing, you're dealing with real dangerous sort of people in terms of criminals that are capable of acts of real atrocity and sort of stuff. So are we going to see that really, really full on? Or is it mellowed a bit?
It's interesting that you say that because one of the things that I think makes the Rookie universe, and I'm going to be calling it that moving forward, because there is so much hope and intention that they will continue to build, and there'll be another kind of Rookie show and another kind, so that we build this universe. I've always thought that one of the things that has made the Rookie universe unique and special is that there is a comedy to it, that despite the fact that we are sitting in serious situations, for example, in the original, in the Mothership, in the Rookie, they're all LAPD police officers and they're on the streets and they're dealing with a bunch of muck and mire and all kinds of madness on the streets. And yet there's always moments throughout where they'll take a moment to see how ridiculous something might be and make a joke about it, or crack a joke, or lighten the mood, or lighten what it is. And I think it's the same thing with ours in the Rookie Feds. We have an incredible, incredible comedic genius in Niecy Nash, who is also now finding her way in the world of drama, which is also beautiful to watch and be I'm sort of privileged to be alongside her to watch it all as it unravels for her and comes together for her. But they do. Yes, we, the Rookie universe, always will have a little bit of lightness. But to answer your question more directly, yes. The fact, here's what happens. When it's on an LAPD level, there are certain things that occur. But it tips over into the FBI when it becomes that much more dangerous, when it becomes that much more serious, when instead of, for example, one murder, there are two, three, four. That's when it escalates and it elevates to a federal level. And that's when we come in. So yes, you're right. The majority of the cases that we will have to handle throughout the season will be ones that are a bit more serious, a bit more elevated in their intensity and in their graphic nature. Now, that being said, you will see that, because again, the signature of our universe is that despite all of that, there are moments of brevity, there are moments of light, there are moments of absurdity, and there's moments of, you know, did you just say that? I think you just said, did you just say that? You know, and we go on. But yes, yeah, you'll see as the shows unravel, there are it can get pretty intense, sure.
And Felix Solis, I believe it's a busy time for you in terms of other things coming our way in 2023. I do believe you were talking to us before we came on air about a possibility of a Netflix show.
There's this fantastic project. It's still in the works and it's doing really, really well at Netflix. It's a project that Jerry Seinfeld wrote, created, is starring in, and it's his first time directing. And it's called Unfrosted. And it's a very, very, very funny telling story of the sort of the origins and the creations and the machinations of all kinds of weird things that occur that ultimately create what we know as the Pop-Tart, the American Pop-Tart treat. And so it's a fascinating, funny project that is in process, and it should hopefully find its way onto everyone's screen on Netflix soon. And I'm so kind of honored and proud to have been asked to play a small part in that movie. So yeah, that's exciting.
And Felix Solis, for the last 30 seconds now of this interview, before we let you go, you might enlighten all our viewers, all our listeners here in Ireland, why they should tune in to the Rookie Feds and turn on their TV screen, sit down with their family, friends and loved ones, and what's in store for them.
You know, I think that the world that we're living in right now has put us in this beautiful, beautifully sad place of having to find levity and find entertainment and find ways to sort of distract ourselves from the true kind of drama that is happening in our lives every day. And so to sit and watch a procedural now seems so much more fulfilling than it would, for example, when there were times when we felt like everything was okay. And the world we're living in right now could use a little bit of procedural, could use a little bit of what happens this week, could use a little bit of honest relationships between two characters that make you wonder and make you laugh and make you want to cry and so on and so forth. But for me, ultimately, the procedural offering with some brevity and some laughter is actually a really kind of welcomed respite, you know, from what is really going on in the world, you know. So I say, if you needed an option to sort of check out from the real world, then check into the Rookie Feds, you know.
Yeah. On that note, Felix Solis, pleasure joining us on the airwaves this evening to talk about the Rookie Feds, which is debuting here in Ireland and the UK at the moment. Do check it out. It's on Channel Sky Witness. It features an all-star cast, including Felix Solis, Niecy Nash, James Lesure, Britt Robertson, to name but a few. We look forward to that Netflix production when our hits are way, and hopefully we can have you back sometime in the near future to talk about that, Felix. And hopefully next time, in between that, you might get a tiny bit off in that sort of 22 episode season to got over in the airplane, have a quick stop off in Ireland, and have a
I might have to, because I look forward to that, being able to sit down and have a pint. Everyone's told me it's my kind of country, and I look forward to that. I look forward to meeting it and experiencing it for the first time. I really do.
On that note, Felix Solis, stay safe, take care, and God bless.
Thank you, friend. Thank you.